Hello everybody, welcome back. This is VTech. In this video, we're going to show you how to get a Game Boy emulator as well as a Nintendo DS emulator. I just wanted to clarify that I already downloaded both the Game Boy and Nintendo DS emulator. So when I go to the Play Store, it'll already have them installed. But I'm going to show you anyway which apps to install. So first things first, you go to the Play Store. And you search up Game Boy Emulator. The first suggestion that comes up is My Boy Free GBA Emulator. This is the one I've always been using. So I recommend this app to use. So you install it and then you'd press open. But to use that, you definitely need ROMs, Game Boy Advance ROMs. And to do that, you go to your internet browser. And there's a website called coolrom.com. And if this would load, I believe this is for Nintendo DS. So if we go back and search, let's say Pokemon Emerald ROM. Hold up. Pokemon Emerald ROM. So it's still coolrom.com. And then once it loads, it'll give you a download link. And to download it from the internet, you need to checkmark off unknown sources from your settings app, from your settings. So it says download now. And I already have it, so I don't need to download it. So I'll go to My Boy GBA Emulator. Now it shows 2.zip files, but obviously Soul Silver is for Nintendo DS. So let's go to Pokemon Emerald. You guys just saw me do Pokemon Silver. When I press it, it says unrecognized GBA file. It will not work. You need a separate Nintendo DS file for that. So let's go to Pokemon Emerald. And it'll work. So it works. Now let's go back. And the second application is for Nintendo DS. Now I did have some trouble finding a decent Nintendo DS emulator because I read the reviews. Not all of them are great except Drastic DS emulator. And sadly I don't have $6 to buy it. So I was able to buy the free version. But the free version only lets you play for 30 minutes. But anyway, I still installed it. And I also installed NDS for Droid. You can do this one too, but it's kind of slower. And I'll show you in a little bit. So I did download both. And first, let's go to Drastic Demo. Load new game. Pokemon Soul Silver. Start game. Touch the screen to continue. This one is much faster than NDS for Droid. And you can see right on the top, it says 29 minutes and 43 seconds remaining. So that's Drastic. And now we'll go to NDS for Droid. And when you open the application, it'll show you all the .zip files. And the only one that can recognize is Pokemon Soul Silver. So let's go to that. You can see it's loading, and this one took a really long time to load, actually, for the first time, so it shouldn't take as long. But when it does load, you'll be able to see the difference of how fast Drastic DS emulators versus this one. Look at the animation when it gets to the start screen. It is much, much slower. So I'm still working on it. I'm most likely gonna have to buy the drastic DS emulator. And what I was thinking was, if I'm able to screen record it, I will screen record every single Pokemon adventure. I'll start off with DS and maybe go Game Boy, or start from Game Boy and go DS. But to do this, I need a screen recorder on my Android device. And just to clarify as well, this is only for Android. I do not have any iPhone, so I can't show you how it works on iOS. I showed you how it can work on Android. And to do this, I believe it doesn't require any latest software. Even though my devices are running Android 4.4.4 KitKat. So that's that for Nintendo DS and Game Boy emulator. Be sure to like this video, comment, and best of all, subscribe for more updates and more videos to come. Thanks for watching, everybody. I hope you guys enjoy this video. And until next time, this is VTech.